help me. Please. Someone. Hello. Please. Just tell me what you think I've done.
What I think you've done? You're not very introspective, Stephen.
Please, come here and we'll talk about it.
You just need some more thinking time.
Come back. Let's talk. Let's keep talking.
Keep away! You stand right back. Let me through. The message I have to get through. A message? Let me get this message through.
Put your weapon down. We'll talk.
No!
Jesus!
So?
You do a pretty good imitation of my sister. My wife, for that matter.
What's the first thing you need to do?
Check no witnesses. Ready, aim, fire.
Yeah, simultaneously to minimise paperwork.
No, the first thing you need to do is reduce your own level of fear. Yes, your own. You've got one person agitated and excited. The last thing the situation needs is for everyone else to get caught up in that excitement, just escalating the confusion. But I've got a weapon, and psychotic people are frightening. So what do we do when we're frightened? We try to control. But unless you know what you're controlling, what their private logic is, you risk adding to their delusional state. So, for example, I've often done this. You're delusional. You've just had an episode. I'm the cop. What happens now?
You don't seem much of a threat sitting on the floor.
Exactly. So, we might be able to talk. So, sometimes we have to pantomime being unthreatening, even to that degree. Okay, your turn.
Yes.
In order for me to do my report, you need to help me understand what happened that morning.
Oh, gosh. It's just so overwhelming.
What is?
Well, being in trouble with the law. When it's your first time.
Right. Now, you told the magistrate in court that you couldn't remember what happened that morning.
That's right. I still can't remember.
Have you ever suffered from blackouts or epilepsy?
No.
And the man whose car you damaged, you didn't know him?
He was unfamiliar. Very unfamiliar.
Unfamiliar?
A stranger. If that sounds weird, it's just because I'm nervous.
So why did you choose his car then?
Believe me, I know how weird this sounds. Why do you think I'm so ashamed?
Well, can you help me understand why you wanted to harm this man's car? It was a very special sort of car, wasn't it? A Citroen. I mean, there were other cars parked in the street, but you chose that one.
Okay.
Was it envy, perhaps?
Envy? Yes. Oh, yes, it was. You know how some days things aren't going so well? Well, that's what came over me that day. One bill after another to cope with, and I went for a walk, and I saw that car, and I thought, oh, gosh, why do some people have all the luck? And I was sort of overwhelmed with envy. I wish I'd just said that in court, but it sounds so, so nutty, really. But that's what it was. It was envy. Aren't you going to write that down?
You seem to accept that explanation very easily, Ellie. Envy.
Well, doesn't that just mean you're good at your job?
Look, we're going to have to finish up now, but I'd really like to see you again tomorrow, if that's okay. I'll get Stevie to find you some time.
Yes, Jane?
Yeah, hi. Could we fit Ellie Potson in tomorrow, preferably, or the day after?
Sure, I'll have a look.
Thanks. Stevie will give you some time.
Okay.
This was really just a stupid one-off thing.
Well, we'll talk some more tomorrow, okay?
What?
What time is it?
Calls me down for a time check. For a prisoner, you're not very tactical. What difference does it make?
Look, my wife's having a baby. Just let me go if you don't know what to do with me. I won't tell anyone.
After we talk.
I'll talk now. Tell me.
Stephen, when I'm ready, and not before. It's not up to you. That's why you're the one tied up, and I'm the one walking around. What's that on the floor?
I'll wait myself.
Ugh.
What do you devil expect? Please, come back. Come back, please.
No, I... No! No, you'll cheat.
Oh.
Letting it breathe. Final chance for you to improve your score.
Final?
Mm-hmm. Next week you can test me.
Oh, what is my score?
0 out of 30.
You wish.
Hunter Valley Cabernet. Bit of Merlot, maybe Chambousin. I'd say about 5 years old. 4, 2, 1, yet to be born.
It's a 98 Shiraz from Tasmania.
Well, at least I got the hemisphere right.
You're the best loser I know.
Not if I lost you, I wouldn't be.
What?
Oh, this boyfriend I had once, utter snob, and driving through France on this supposed holiday.
Oh, you took a holiday.
And every vineyard we'd screech to a halt, we'd have to play Impress the Winemaker in this appalling French. I was so embarrassed I used to sit in the car.
Actually, we're going to the vineyards this weekend if I can get away. And I wish it was us going to the country. I'd like to be able to do that.
Yes, and we can't. And we know how this works. We like how this works. I'll tell you something.
What?
I lied, it's from the Barossa.
Oh!
Something the matter?
No. No. It's just the fabrics don't match. I didn't notice yesterday. And things have been moved around.
Well, the cleaners were in last night.
You write books. I've seen them in the shops, I'm sure.
Yes, that's right.
I'm writing a book. That's why I noticed. It must be great to be published. I started to remember more about the incident with the car.
Well, that's good. Have a seat.
Careful, she's watching. She's watching. Be careful, be careful. She's cooking.
Perhaps, yeah, at first it was envy, but then it was self-defense. I had to defend myself. I was looking at the car, admiring it. But then out he bounded. He started coming for me. He must have thought that I was a car thief or something. And then he tried to smother me completely.
Concentrate the plan. That's a plan. Concentrate.
Concentrate. Get it right. Concentrate. Get it right.
Bastard!
What the bloody hell are you doing?
Smother you?
He lunged at me. Lunged. He blocked out the sun. I'm not very big.
Ellie, you splashed the car with acid. Do you normally carry a container of acid with you when you go for a walk?
Does that seem odd? Like an odd thing to do?
Yes, it does.
Then I am very sure I will not do it again.
Tell me about your upbringing.
My parents adore each other. Adore. Same little house all these years.
You and your mother?
I speak every night on the phone.
What about your father?
He still calls me princess. I'm 28 years old, for heaven's sake, Dad. But he does. Do you know what he called our house? Havenwood. Havenwood.
And growing up in Seaspray, how was that?
Perfect. I'd go back tomorrow if I could.
Ellie, were you ever sexually abused as a child?
Oh, come on.
It's a standard question I have to ask.
Well, I'm really sorry, but I find that an insult. I am a lesbian for one reason only. Women turn me on. I like their lips and their throats and their breasts and their bellies and their thighs. A lot. I like the way they tilt their head on one side and scratch their chin.
I didn't ask the question because of your sexual affiliation. I didn't know.
Yes, you did. You've been flirting with me since I came into your room. That's okay. Everyone's a pervert, one way or another.
It's an interesting thought.
If you're trying to crack on, I'm spoken for.
Ellie, I'm just trying to write a better report.
I have nothing left in me to say. I'm empty.
Oh, my God. Well, there we are. You should have been more patient. I would have let you go, you stupid prick. Let you off with a warning. Consider yourself warned. Listen, did you manage to fit in Ellie Potson for tomorrow?
Yes, but part of my job description is to remind you that you only get paid for a single evaluation.
Yeah, I just want to find out more about what she was like in court. You'll need to speak to Gina at Corrective Services. She's tough as nails, but she'll talk to you.
What if she asks me when she can expect your report?
Speak to the hand, not the face. Come on. Have a look.
Did you kill him?
No. He did it himself.
All I wanted was to ask them to stop.
You should have come down like that.
When?
Well, I don't know. Last time I saw Stephen was 2-3 months ago. He seemed fine. He was excited about the baby. Said work was picking up.
And?
Well, that's it.
He has not been home for 2 days. I have left heaps of messages on his mobile. He won't answer my calls.
Well, it's between you two.
Brooke, you are his oldest friend.
I wouldn't say that.
Look, I know he's changed since he's been involved in this bloody gambling business.
You think he's in trouble?
No. He has been screwing around again. Well, he will not see his kid, I can tell you that right now.
Just calm down.
God. Look, could you just, you know, please ring him for me and just tell him to wake up to himself and come home before it's too late.
It says Brooke. It must be Brooke Gibson. He's on the phone. He's trying to track us down. They'll be tracing us by satellite.
Not anymore, they won't.
Don't use that. They'll trace where it came from.
Do you want me to think for us or not?
Sorry, that took longer than I thought.
Well, that's okay.
Gina sure can talk.
What did she say about Ellie?
Well, in a nutshell, she felt that Ellie was bunging it on in court, trying to play loony. Her theory is Ellie was seeing the guy on the side, he dumped her, she threw acid on his car.
Is that what she's putting in her report?
She's waiting on yours, pronto.
Look, I'm late. Could you run this over to Ellie's for me? She's not answering my calls and I need it signed.
Yeah, sure. Gina also said she was tired of working with pathological liars and wishes for once they'd do what they were told.
Sounds like corrective services.
I think she meant you as well.
Oh.
Have fun at the book signing.
Thanks.
You know, killing him. No, it's worse. You made it worse.
You weren't here.
Yeah, well, I never got to talk to him. It was all I wanted was to talk.
Spirits take days to leave the body. He can hear every word we say.
We were going to take you to the castle. Then you would have known to tell the others to stop. That was all.
Yeah. They hear about this, they'll shit themselves. Never bother us again.
It's Jane's assistant.
What's she doing here? Burning.
It's because she needs me at her book launch. I've got to go.
Where have you got to go?
Why is everything always about you?
You're not going anywhere until you help me get that in a van.
I have to keep her on side. She's a shrink. Otherwise I'll be further up this shit. I've got to go.
I thrive on true crime. I haven't read anything else for years.
Does it affect you, do you think, living inside the criminal mind?
Make it out to Roger.
Oh, right. Roger.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Did you make it out to Mandy?
Yes, I write. I do. A lot. It's such a great release writing a novel. You know, everything's all... And then it just let it all out onto the page. Everything just comes pouring out. Please.
So what's it about, your book?
Oh, it'll take too long. She can wait 5 minutes. Let her wait. It's called Vigilance. These people trapped on this hillside, high on a villa, as trapped as though they were in chains. And this thunderous war rages all around them, and they tell stories about their pasts. It's about repression and purity and control, all sorts of other things.
Do you think people try to control us?
Do I think that?
Do you worry that people might try?
But they do try. And I'm very susceptible because I'm weak. I've got kind of a fluid personality. I'm easily convinced. I'm not crazy, I'm just weak.
Tell me about your girlfriend.
Well, she's very strong. Incredibly. Ever since we met at the girly bar 7 years ago, we've been bonded at the hip. Well, this is the throat.
And how do you feel about that?
Oh, good. Yeah, free will. It's overrated, really.
I'm wondering, Ellie, does your girlfriend try to control you?
Oh, I don't think that growing lettuces is my life ambition. She wanted a business where we could work together, just the two of us. Self-sufficiency.
I see.
And every day we would pass that car, that vintage Citroen, and she'd say, I hate that car, blah, blah, blah. And eventually I thought, oh, God, sweetheart, let's just do something about it. And I threw the acid because I have this pathological desire to please people. It was a stupid adolescent mistake. I put you and everybody else to so much trouble over what was really just a prank. Thank you for inviting me. I'm late, she'll go ballistic.
Now, Ellie, look, make a time to come and talk to me. We'll talk about your book, all right?
Excuse me, Dr. Halifax. I bought a second copy.
Very tasty.
She wants to get into my knickers. I said probably not.
Hey, step back.
Good morning. I'm Jane Halifax. I'm a psychiatrist. I'm assessing the woman who threw acid on your car.
Prove it. I just got it back.
Could you tell me what actually happened that morning?
Well, this girl, she just sort of went nuts.
As in?
Well, I came through the gate here. I was on my way to work. She yelled something. I turned to see who she was yelling at, and she was running at me with this open jar. I thought it was just water. And then she turned and chucked it over the car. She seemed pretty confused.
I don't recall reading that in the report, that you thought she was running at you.
Just wanted the insurance. Get it over and done with.
And you didn't know her?
No.
Can I ask how long you've lived here?
Almost a year.
Any idea who lived here before you?
Brooke someone, gardener, horticulturalist or something. Gibson, Brooke Gibson. Yeah, still get the magazines. Could you not lean on the car?
Sorry.
Thank you.
Stop.
Point.
The smoke. It's sucking everything up. It's taking it all away.
That's the power that sets us apart.
Did your husband have any enemies, Mrs. Weston?
No. Stephen didn't have an enemy in the world.
No business problems?
No.
He sold gaming machines, you said?
He leases them. You know, all the latest ones to pubs and clubs.
I'm sorry to have to ask you this, Mrs. Weston, but is it possible that your husband was involved with another woman?
Stephen? My God, absolutely not. I mean, he adored me. We adored each other.
Once in my life. I have to have my own space.
When don't you?
I'm sorry, Karen, it's just that your hands smell. Like fertilizer. He's stopping me from writing.
The water. There's something wrong with the water. I told you not to touch them.
I didn't. Maybe they've been poisoned.
They're sending stuff through the mains. The meter's jumping all over the place. I'm gonna have to turn the water off outside. I'm gonna have to flush it. Flush everything.
Oh, listen, hold on, okay?
See this table here? It's a warning. Telling us they're back in control.
This is so unfair. You told me it was gonna stop. You promised me.
They don't realize it was us who killed him.
I'm gonna have to let them know.
Crop pathology back on the crispy critter. Not much to report, mate. It's not enough left of him.
All right, well, he's left a trail of dodgy poker machines, so I'll see what gaming's got to those cops.
Jane. Come in here so I can exploit you. I'm not sure if anybody's told you, but your session next week might end up clashing...
with the union meeting, yeah, I know.
I enjoyed the other night.
Yeah, me too. Oh, that's an interesting face.
Not anymore. He was burnt to a crisp, poor bastard. My guess, it's either revenge or sexual fun and games gone horribly wrong.
Either or. Well, when you can afford a profiler, call me.
Well, you can see how high you think I can go with it. A penguin, maybe even higher, maybe sell a film rights.
People
love stories like this, full of detail. Like that man whose body they found burnt? Yeah, burning flesh smells quite sweet. Well, that's not something you'd expect.
How do you know that?
What?
What burning flesh smells like?
I'm a reader, I read.
Does it upset you when you read stories like that?
No.
So, how long have you and Karen been together, Emma?
The recorder, she's stealing my thoughts. She's one of them. She's stealing my thoughts.
Right.
About 7 or 8 years. She needs a family, Karen. Her mother was quite mad, apparently. She has a lot of pain inside her head.
Does she tell you that?
No. I can just tell.
Has she been on medication for this?
No. Concentrate. Right.
Has she ever had any psychiatric treatment?
No.
Ellie, the day that you threw the acid on the car...
Oh, that old story. Tell me how you write, with a pen or at the computer.
What were you planning to do, Ellie? Were you actually intending to harm the car or the man himself?
The car. I told you, Karen didn't like the car. I obliged.
Or maybe it was more than the car. Maybe this was someone that Karen wanted you to harm or intimidate.
Intimidate?
So this was someone that she knew?
No, he was just someone around.
So she asked you to do this and you said yes?
I knew she wanted to test me. Would I do it for her? There's always some sort of a test going on, let me tell you. What she says goes. Being a princess has its price.
Ellie, have you ever lived alone? Have you ever considered living alone?
No.
And what would it take, do you think, for you to consider living alone?
She's got... Don't. Shut up. Leave me alone. Shut up.
Cram.
Get out. Get out now. You're going to make us split up.
How does that make you feel?
I think I've made a terrible mistake.
Ellie, wait!
Silly, stupid bitch. What are you thinking?
Shut up. She's coming to
split us up. Split us up. Alone. I'm gonna be alone. Karen, I'm gonna be alone.
You left your book with her? Well, what's it got in it? Stuff about me?
No. Ideas, experiences. Oh, you can't stop me writing things down.
Don't turn against me, mate. I'm the one trying to help.
She made out she was on my side. I thought she'd know people. Publishers.
So now Muggins here has to go and get it back. The treasurer said many people. Well, lucky for you, I'm getting good at tracking people down. Look at this. Look.
Jane Halifax is sending through the information about you. She is only pretending she's on your side. Victorian scientists have found the key to growing nerve cells.
Ellie! I want you to look at this. Recognize him?
Anywhere near him.
Please make it all stop. Please make it all stop. Well, there's only one way to do that, Ellie. We have to talk to him on our terms. And we know now we can. But you're going to have to be a very, very strong girl.
Jane Halifax. Snake in the grass.
Reading of the manuscript she left with me confirms my suspicions that she's what? She's curiously fluid and changeable in her identity. The sense when one interviews her that she's a mouthpiece for someone else, which could be her girlfriend. So Certainly there's a strong degree of codependency from Ellie towards her partner. Maybe that's what's going on.
Evil is all around her, swirling, clutching at her soul, refusing her peace or freedom. She could only wait for the brightness of the flames that would send her soul into the nether regions of space and never return.
Come here. Look.
From the opposite apartment, you could see straight in.
She'd have it like that to help her broadcast everything her patients say. Do you think? She's the ringleader of all of them. It's all part of her plan. This is where she gets her mail from.
33. Nice number.
Hello?
It's Jay.
Hi, it's me.
Thank you, after you.
Well, this is a surprise.
I just dropped by to see if you had any bloke things you needed doing.
Oh, bloke things. What, like rearranging the bedroom?
I could make a start.
Oh, goody.
Well, and there I was sweating I'd get the lecture.
Well, the lecture being?
Stick to the rules. See you next Wednesday. Mm-hmm. You should have phoned first. Mm-hmm. I do have a life of my own.
Oh, that's close, but I'm not your mother.
That's what it is. You're not my mother.
See, this idea about me.
Yes, I'm afraid I do.
That I'm in control and organizing and organized.
Here, you're just a quivering mess.
Well, maybe a bit.
At least you didn't give him my book.
Listen, when we get up there, you let me do the talking.
Ellie. Ellie's made a mistake. She'd like a book back, please. Close the door. I've been together for quite a few years now, as a couple.
Yes, I know.
We've got a business together. We like to work together. We'll be together for the rest of our lives.
I understand.
Okay, if I check the view?
No. I prefer the door closed. So you will have noticed she likes the spotlight, Ellie.
Karen, could I invite you and Ellie to my offices tomorrow? I think you'd be
I suppose you call it attention-seeking.
Not necessarily.
This thing she's in trouble for instance. She won't have told you why it happened. She's been wasting your time, fabricating lies. It's because she wanted me to buy her a car, and I said no. Simple as that. So she does this thing to make me feel guilty, so next time I'll give her exactly what she wants.
That's the truth. Not very nice.
You can tell the court, you have my word, she won't do it again.
Well, that's very helpful.
And if you just give her a book back, we'll get out of your hair.
I think I left it at the office.
Oh, really? Well, why don't we go there right now? Have you got a ladder?
In the cupboard.
Quick, go. It's all right. I've disabled it. Your battery's gone. Fire in this place and you'd be stuffed.
Karen was in a hotel fire once. The Excelsior.
Well, I'll replace the battery first thing. And I did bring the book back after all, so...
Are you sure you wouldn't like a second opinion?
She wouldn't.
Oh, thanks anyway.
Well, if you change your mind. Now, I don't mean to be rude, but...
Oh, you're not rude. Oh, we're the ones who just turned up.
Oh, thanks for noticing the alarm.
No jumping out the window this far up, unless you were pushed.
Gee, She notices everything. She's amazing.
Good night.
The feeling at the Excelsior Hotel was that Karen was one tough nut. She got into a knife fight once when someone tried to hit on a girlfriend.
Nice.
There's also a bit of a rumour that she may have started the fire. She left town straight after and she resurfaced a year later.
That's interesting.
Yeah, apparently she used to go on a lot about being brought up in one of those McAllister homes too, if that's any help.
Right. Any chance you could find out where the McAllister home records could be found?
And corrective services rang. They would like the report on Ellie Potsdam, preferably yesterday.
Well, stall them. My gut feeling is it's not Ellie we should be worried about.
I'm not really sure how I can help you.
Part of my job is to, construct a picture of what Stephen's like.
I can't believe he's dead. Poor Tanya.
His wife said you were quite close. Known each other since you were 16, 17.
Yeah. We played cricket together when we were younger. We just, you know, touch base from time to time. Have a drink, go home.
How was his business doing?
Pretty up and down. Well, that'd be my guess. I haven't seen him much since he started this poker machine business.
What was that?
Different worlds, I guess. He was always out at clubs and stuff.
Did you meet or hear of any business associates that he might have had problems with? Did you know he was charged with assault a few years back?
No.
But it wouldn't surprise you.
Well, he was always pretty wild, Steve-O. That's just how he was.
Did he ever mention any problems with money? Anyone he might have crossed?
We never talked about stuff like that.
Would you have known if he was having an affair, seeing someone on the side?
Not with Tanya and the baby on the way. I think he'd changed, grown up a bit.
Is there anyone else you think we could talk to?
No, it's all right.
Well, you got my card. You might think of something while you're out gardening. There is one more thing. What's the best stuff for powdery mildew on roses?
You what?
Powdery mildew on roses.
Oh, you want to prune them out to open up the centre and fungicide when you first see the signs.
Right. Thanks, mate. It's been driving my wife nuts.
Cancelled. Oh, we're sorry, Karen. We're ordering from someone else. You know what this is? Interference. Led by that shrink, I bet.
You understand this? Do you love me?
I have worked my ass off to set this up. No one's going to close us down, not that smug bitch. Not those blokes.
I don't think it's a secret. The McAllister group homes were shockers.
I'm looking for a Karen Oldfield.
You'll have to wade through. Sorry.
So they had these group homes all over the state?
6 to 8 kids of different ages and a house mother, usually untrained, trying to cope. These are the newsletters they would have used for fundraising. It's all a mess till I write the book. They were going to throw those out, so I grabbed them. I'll leave you to it.
Thanks.
Right. I found the perfect time when he's completely alone 3 nights a week. Look.
I don't want to.
Look at him, Ellie. It's for your own good. I want to ruin your business. I want to break up your relationship. I want to get inside your head. I want to send you mad.
Can I get a copy of this?
Sure.
Weston. Weston. Oh, that
That's an interesting face.
Not anymore. He was burnt to a crisp, poor bastard.
Now, this could be a long shot, OK?
Just as long as this is not a long, long shot.
This homicide of yours, Stephen Weston.
Yep.
Well, I might have something.
Why the sudden interest in my work?
Because it may involve one of my patients.
So is this to help me and my case, or you and your maddies?
Well, maybe both.
Come in.
Sorry to interrupt.
No, not at all. Anna, this is Jane Halifax. Jane, this is my wife, Anna.
Oh, nice to meet you.
And you. Brett's told me a lot about you.
Really?
Very interesting work. Oh,
very much so, yes.
Yeah, well, keeps me on my toes. Well, that's it, really, so...
What was your question? Something about Stephen Weston.
Oh, if you could just find out if he spent any time in Sea Spray as an adolescent. Like I said, it's
a long shot. No, I'll follow that up. Thanks.
Okay. Well, have a nice night.
Thanks. We always do. Bye.
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 She seems very nice.
Yeah.
And the frustrating thing is this cricket article was the only reference. And I trawled through as many files as I could. Zilch.
Stephen Weston's a pretty common name. No, it's spelled with an I-N, it's not. And, of course, the bloody records are a complete dog's breakfast. And it puts him in the same age range as the murder victim. And the other thing is, why would Ellie keep telling me that she met Karen in a bar when obviously they would have known each other growing up?
Except that I met heaps of people from my town I never saw when I was living there.
Yeah, but Seaspray's a tiny town. And if they knew each other, what if Stephen Weston was in the home and they knew him as well?
Well, what if they did? You think they killed him?
Not to mention the fact that my patient, a day after they find the body, tells me very confidently that she knows what burning flesh smells like.
Sounds like a perfect excuse during that cute detective.
Oh, if it's the cute detective, I think you mean he's busy. On a date.
Oh.
With his wife. Very warm and fuzzy.
So I was right. You're having an affair. Wouldn't have picked you as a type.
It's nothing. I don't know what it is.
You know, the good ones never leave their wives.
It's your shout, isn't it?
That flashing light.
Telling us we're on the right track. One, two, three. One, two, three. Come on.
Why don't you just do it? I'll stay here.
No, Ellie. You have to help. You have to talk to him. Remember what he did to you.
I have to talk to him. Keep evil at bay.
Okay there?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks. I used to work in a service station. Actually, though, if you could give me a hand, I was supposed to get home to pick up the kids.
Yeah, not a problem.
Thanks.
These are tricky.
First thing I learnt when I started driving, how to change a tyre. But sometimes they just put the nuts on too tight.
Well, you sure had a strong guy who put these on, all right?
This gentleman's giving us a hand.
That's very nice of you. Would you like a cool drink? It's a sports drink.
Oh, I'm fine, thanks. This really shouldn't take too long.
Go!
Sit!
It's not working. I did it wrong.
Wait. You don't understand, do you, Jerry?
You're working against us. All we wanted was to be left alone. Do you understand now, Jerry Eckler? You have to stay out of our lives. We're going to take you to the castle. We're going to show you what it's like.
Can't you see? He's sucking your flesh. Can you feel it?
Whack him!
Your flesh! Your...
I don't love him. I can't do it.
No, I can't. I don't
love him.
He's one of them.
How can it be wrong?
Do it.
It's not wrong. It's not.
Do it. Do it.
He's all three.
Do it.
Whack him.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
Do it. Do it.
This is what sets us apart. Ah, what a lovely day. It's heavenly.
Why is that, Ellie?
Oh, one of those days where everything goes right. Don't you ever get that feeling in the flow where life is a dance and you've just remembered the steps? It's a line from my book. This is the way I usually am, by the way. I'm generally a really happy person.
Ellie, the last time we spoke about this court matter, you said that throwing the acid on the car had been Karen's idea and that you'd done it for her.
Jane, how many women do you know would not like acid chucked on some punsy, rich guy, smart-ass, precious car?
Yes, but when you came to my apartment the other night, Karen said that you'd done it to spite her, and you agreed.
Keep the story straight. I only said that to please her.
Yeah, but you did seem a little nervous of Karen, Ellie. You described it as being under the thumb, do you remember? How many years between you both in age?
Three. Four, something.
I was just wondering whether you knew each other growing up. I mean, Seaspray's a tiny town. You would have known about the McAllister group home where Karen lived.
Did she?
I think you know she did.
That's right. Yes, she did. I only saw her around. She was 3 years older than me. It's a lot when you're a kid. And when we met up at the girly bar 7 years later, we marveled at the coincidence.
Ellie, is Karen sometimes violent? Maybe towards you.
I don't like this.
You told me that she encouraged you to throw the acid on the car. Are there other things that she coerces you to do?
No.
Ellie, the other day you were talking about the man whose body was found burnt. You seemed really interested in it. His name was Stephen Weston.
Was it? I didn't know.
Well, do you think Karen might have known?
Here's your chance. Tell her.
Maybe he was with Karen in the home in Seaspray.
I need. No. It's there. It's there. The answer. Clear your brain.
She didn't know. She would have said when we were reading the paper. Why?
I just wondered.
We just read the papers and saw the news and said, what a terrible thing.
Ellie, as part of your probation, I'm considering a recommendation that you and Karen receive joint and independent counselling. Now, I can explain this to Karen if you'd like. Do you understand why I'm going to suggest this?
No. No.
She saved.
Karen saves me.
What do you mean by that, Ellie?
I really, really, really didn't think that you would.
That I would what?
I really didn't think that you would stoop so low.
Ellie, please, don't! Ellie!
Okay, I'll tell her. Thank you. That was your cop friend, Brett. He said thanks for the lead, but it's not the same person.
Right,
Another runner.
Yeah. Could you give her half an hour and then give her a call?
Okay.
Mr. Elliot, hi, come through.
Jesus, she knows things.
Hang on.
She has definitely been recruited and she knows things about you.
What?
We were so naive to think that they'd stopped. They're trying to split us up through the courts. It's the next plan.
Excuse
Excuse me, you can't go in there.
I've had enough of you. We've had enough of you trying to rip us apart.
Take Mr. Elliot outside.
So if I'm the bitch goddess, you might like to tell me to my face. Here, listen to this. See if you can pick anything up.
Well, you're obviously upset.
You write things about me. You tell me first.
I'm not writing about you.
Ellie, look at this place. It's an electronic minefield. It's like bloody NASA in here. This is where you've been blah, blah, blabbing away everything. Oh, because I have to be everyone's little girl.
Shut up.
You're supposed to be the one who can see. She's been dragging out your insides, broadcasting them on satellites. I mean, look at this, and this, and this stuff about us. Look at this.
It's a television aerial code.
She's got you too. I can't see your mouth. She has no...
I don't have her.
Where's your face? No! No! The things I have done for you, the things I have done, I am burning up. Oh, help me, Karen. Save me. I'm burning. Prove it. I can prove it. I've done every other bloody thing I can to prove it. I can definitely prove that. No! Keep away!
Karen, you don't want to do this. Karen, you don't want to do this. Don't do this. Karen, don't hurt yourself. Karen, listen to me.
I've lost her. It's all my fault.
Oh, it's not your fault, Ellie. Ellie, listen to me. Karen isn't well. My guess is she's been needing help for some time and you've been trying to cope. And the thing is, whatever's been going on for Karen, it's been affecting you too. Now, this can happen even if we don't realize. I want to talk to you about what's going to happen next.
Like what?
I'm going to have to treat Karen. So I'd like you to see a colleague of mine. Her name's Kate Lee. Do you think you can do that for me?
When can I see Karen?
In a couple of days.
Thanks for looking after me.
It's okay. Now you just sit here. I'll be right back. Put someone away today. One half of a pair. Folie à deux. Ever do that in psych?
No, that'll be the lecture I missed.
Means a shared insanity.
I wonder what we had.
My patient was starting to appropriate her partner's madness. It's really hard to pick. And the partner's that woman I asked you to look up for me.
Which I'll deny in court.
And she's also the one I think knew Stephen Weston.
Jane, my Stephen Weston lived on his parents' farm near Dubbo until he was 20. He never left. I've done the searches, I've talked to his wife. And my Stephen Weston
had a list of people as long as my arm, only too happy to bump him off. Not the same guy. So this folly thing is what? One person who's sane?
Usually needy and submissive, so they're predisposed. I mean, they even start to believe in the delusions too. Signs, voices, whatever.
Until they're separated.
Yeah. The same one recovers within 3 or 4 days. Folie à deux. Ménage à toi. Surtout le quatre.
Oh, I love it when you talk French.
It's not quite what my French teacher used to say.
I love you, you know.
No, you don't.
I'm leaving Anna. I've decided.
What?
It's what's best. She's, well, the two of us. I mean, we've known each other since we were kids, but, I'm not saying she's not, giving. She's incredibly kind. That's half her problem.
I'm not your therapist.
But this has made me realise that you can't live half a life.
Brett, stop. I'm not going to be the one who breaks up your marriage. From day one, that's been well and truly out of the equation.
You are not breaking up my marriage, I am.
Look, we agreed to that from the start. Tell me we agreed to that.
That was the theory, yeah.
We were clear. Jesus, we were so clear what our boundaries were.
Boundaries change.
Mine haven't.
Jane, we're lovers. We haven't got a bloody workplace enterprise agreement. What I have with you, what we have...
You should have told me you were thinking of doing this.
I am telling you. Jane, I just want to be able to what? To take you to dinner, to see a movie, to drive up the bloody vineyards if we want to wake up in the same bed.
You need to try and make your marriage work.
It's too late for that. I do know that the reason you were attracted to me in the first place was precisely because we couldn't do any of those things. And I do understand that all those messy life things that bind two people together, you keep away from with a barge pole.
I don't.
But can you just tell me, is there any part of you that thinks we may have a future together?
I like what we have.
Offense, but
I thought the theory was that the good ones never leave their wives.
Oh.
Let's just say it's been a long night. Look, I need you to cancel today's appointments. But if Ellie calls, forward her through to me. And ring the psych unit and remind them that no visitors for Karen Oldfield means exactly that. No exceptions. And could you also dig up Ellie Potson's parents' address, please? I think she put it under next of kin. I'm driving down the coast.
How come?
I just want to have a chat to Ellie's parents. Do some research on Karen.
Tanya, it's Brooke Gibson. Hi. Look, a quick question. Do you know, was Stephen ever in touch with a guy named Jerry Eckler? Oh, it's okay. Never mind, forget it. It's just someone whose number I've lost. Yeah, I'm sorry to bother you. And take care of yourself.
Is this the Potson house?
Who?
Ellie Potson, 44 Sandy Crescent. I was given this address.
Our name's Eckler. We've lived here for the past 40 years. If you'll excuse me, we've had a tragedy in the family. Excuse me.
Oh, I'm sorry to have troubled you.
What name was it?
Potson. Ellie Potson. She gave me this address.
I remember.
I don't suppose you'd know where the family lives.
She had no family. She was an orphan or a ward of the state, whatever they call them.
So she would have lived in the McAllister home down here then?
Yes, she certainly did. She's got a cheek saying she lived here. We wouldn't have had her near the place. She was a little tart and she caused so much trouble for my son. If you'll excuse me, I must get back to my wife.
Oh, I'm really sorry to bother you, but I don't suppose you'd know of anyone who used to work at the McAllister home that I could talk to.
The church still owns it. The cost of heating, all that. I know what you think, people like you.
I'm not sure what you mean.
How they must have all been sadists, hell-bent on making their lives a misery.
Do you recall why Ellie Potson came here?
Her parents were killed in a car accident. No one else put up their hands, so we got her.
What was she like?
Ellie was like a baby bird in a nest waiting to be fed. Anything to get attention.
Like what?
Anything and everything to get us all running around.
Did you have any friends?
Only one. An older girl, Oldfield.
Karen?
Karen Oldfield.
Can you tell me about Karen?
Bad home life, brutal, beaten by her parents. She came here when she was just 9 or 10. I don't recall her parents ever contacting her again.
What were she and Ellie like together?
Well, at first we thought it'd be good for Ellie, someone to take care of her. But Ellie started to play on it. Well, the more Karen mollycoddled her, the more demanding Ellie got.
Demanding?
Well, testing her. But Karen always stood by her, no matter what. Even when Ellie... She got into some hot water with some town boys.
What happened?
Oh, she got a crush on one of them. Drove him mad, followed him everywhere. Said she was going to marry him. Poor boy, he was only 16. Anyway, Ellie got hysterical. She was obviously disturbed.
Disturbed?
Well, that's what the doctor said. I had to take her to him when she accused these three boys of raping her. Well, of course they didn't.
Well, how do you know that? Well,
the doctor examined her. She was still a virgin. She made the whole thing up, as usual. Poor Karen decided we were all trying to hush up this rape. Ellie needed protecting from us. Well, the only person Ellie needed protection from was herself. It was the three boys I felt sorry for.
Do you remember the names of the three boys?
Well, one of them was Brooke Gibson. I remember him because his family well known around here. The boy she had the crush on was Jerry Eckler. Very sad about him, you know. He was killed in the city, apparently. Well, a couple of days ago. Saw it in the paper. I wouldn't live up there for love nor money.
And the third?
Oh, he was an out-of-towner.
Stephen Weston.
That sounds familiar. That's right. His family had a holiday house down here.
Oh, look, I'm sorry, but I really have to go.
Okay.
Thanks for your help. Are you sure I can't give you anything?
No, thanks. I'll walk.
Brett, hi, it's Jane. I really need to speak to you. If you can call me as soon as you get this message. Thanks.
A 12-year-old kid shot dead in a drive-by. I haven't got a lot of time.
Well, I've been trying to call you.
I've been flat chat.
There's a guy called Jerry Eckler.
Jerry Eckler was killed 2 days ago.
He knew Stephen Weston. And Karen Oldfield, the woman I told you about.
we'll get a photo of Weston as a kid down to Eckler's parents, see if it's the same guy. Oh,
come on, it's too much of a coincidence that they knew each other.
Weston grew up in Dubbo.
His parents had a holiday house in Seasbury.
But then you factor in Karen Oldfield, same time. Her now girlfriend apparently dumped by Eckler as a kid.
Where's Oldfield now?
In a psych ward under supervision.
How secure?
Look, she can't leave until I sign her out.
Well, we'll pick her up as soon as you do.
There's a third one, Brooke Gibson.
I spoke to Gibson a couple of days ago in regard to Stephen Weston, so we'll pick him up as well, okay?
Thanks for your help. You don't want to come work for us, do you?
No, thanks.
Good night.
Look, Brett, I'm sorry about the other night. I thought we had an understanding.
Did it ever cross your mind at the beginning, even for a moment, that you might fall in love with me? That says a lot more about you than it does about me.
You didn't give me a chance to answer.
Don't worry about it. You should go home and get some sleep.
Run over a possum. A beautiful possum. Oh, it's under the wheel.
Excuse me. Are you all right?
My husband asked me to stop the car to let him throw up. He's a little drunker than I thought. I wonder if you could,
Yeah, sure.
Hoping we could have a talk.
I want to see Ellie. She's hopeless on her own.
I can understand that you're worried about Ellie. She's fine.
I help her interpret the signs, which is why I need to see her.
You'll see her soon, okay? These burns on your arms, Karen, can you tell me about those?
I get pissed off. It helps relieve things. Get rid of the fear. Whatever.
Fear. Oh, God. Oh, God. Fear of the people following you. The ones you call spies.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen these people, Karen?
No, but Ellie's quicker than me. This is all... You're confusing me.
Karen, have you noticed a change in Ellie in the last few years? Has she become more erratic, unpredictable?
Yeah. It started to get worse about the time we moved into the warehouse. You know... Got more... intense.
You never did see those people who were following you, did you? And the voices. You just went along with Ellie, didn't you?
What's gonna happen to us now?
Brett, it's Jane. I've asked for Karen Oldfield to be kept in for another 24 hours, but I really need to speak to you about Ellie, so call me. Okay. Jane Halifax.
Jane, it's me. It's Ellie.
Ellie, you all right?
Sorry to call.
Where are you?
I'm at home.
Could you come over? I'm scared.
I'm on my way.
Here we are, love. Come on, Karen. I've got to see you take it. Good girl. Hello, Gladys. You knitting today?
Wait till you see what I've done by myself.
We could have dumped her at a hospital, just driven off.
People who love people do what they say.
Ellie! We have to stop.
Stop? What have they done to you? I thought you loved me.
I do love you. I love you more than anything.
Then stop whining!
Help me.
People will come looking.
Will they? They didn't come looking for me. Where were they then when you left me there to die?
We didn't leave you to die. We left you for a couple of hours, that's all.
Brock, don't.
We just tried to scare her. Tried to stop her from telling lies.
Lies. You wanted me dead.
Bitch.
You never stopped.
That's not true. We tried to scare you. This was years ago.
Ellie.
Brock, be quiet.
Ellie, listen to me. Listen to me.
And you trying to pretend that they didn't send you. We knew, didn't we, Karen? We knew.
Tell her we knew!
I want to help you, Ellie.
Petrol can. Now! And you can use the lot of it. We're not going to be needing it again. This is Custer's last stand! You first. Get moving, Mrs. Mustard.
This is the prison castle, isn't it, Ellie? This is the castle where they brought you.
You told her.
It was in your book.
Traitor, snapping teeth. Like an alligator.
Ellie, you need help. These voices, they're just confusing you. They're making you sick.
Don't talk to her like that.
And you great clod, hurry up. Any slower, you'd self-combust.
No!
Beg for forgiveness! Beg for forgiveness! Tell her what you did to me. You're trying to get inside me. You're trying to control my body and my mind. Tell her!
We didn't do anything! Please.
You raped her, and now you have to suffer.
Karen, it's not true. It's not true.
No, we didn't rape her, for God's sake. Please. Please.
Liar!
No, please.
Liar!
You mad bitch!
Karen,
no, we didn't.
Ellie, no.
We didn't touch you.
No.
You
love me, stop this!
You stupid cow. You think I could love you? I don't think so.
Please. Stop it. You don't mean that.
Whining voice in your filthy fertilizer fingers. Kill her and redeem yourself. Kill her. Do it.
Karen, listen to me. Ellie needs your help. Karen.
Can you smell the burning? Can you smell
freak.
The
burning?
Freak, you call me a freak, you!
She doesn't know what she's saying. This is all your fault. If you kill us, you're going to be separated for life. Is that what you want?
Your mother's going to smell your flesh, you
victim!
Think about what you've done. Think. We have to do this. They hurt her. Look at her. They ruined her.
They didn't do anything to her. She hasn't been well for a long time, and she's getting worse.
They got into her body, and they took over her brain. Listen to yourself. You know that's not possible. I can't take over her brain. It doesn't make sense.
They did. They took over her mind.
I have to look after her.
How can you? How can you? You have to stop her, Karen.
Leave me alone!
Ellie, no! All I ever wanted to do was help you. All I ever wanted to do was please you.
Oh, you didn't try very hard.
Help me with the demons, you said. Make it all go away. Save me. The things we've done. And all alone, you're the demon, Ellie.
Karen, no, let her go.
You're the demon.
Let her go. Karen, look at me. Don't do this. She needs your help. Let her go. Don't do this. Karen, please. Let her go.
Oh.
you got today, eh?
Oh, you want?
Ah, just one.
I suppose next you'll be running for commissioner.
Head of homicides, more my style.
We'd work well together.
I'd kill you.
Ah, you get used to it.
That's what I'm afraid of.
It's not that bad, you know.
What's that?
Teamwork.
Are we still talking work?
Half your luck, mate. Bring me back a souvenir.
You're going away?
Just taking a bit of leave.
You and Dana.
Yeah. I've been thinking about what you said about, Anyway, so we thought we might go over to the Barossa.
Well, that's good. Oh, I'm pleased, really.
You must be the most independent woman I have ever met.
Well, you should get out more.
I guess.
Well, have a good trip. Find some nice wine.
I'll think of you when I taste the Champs-Élysées.
You do that.